So we'll talk about the drone attack. What happened actually in the drone attack? See, there was a terror attack about two Indian Air Force personnel were injured at the Jammu Air Force when there was a detonation of the unmanned area by the unmanned area vehicles on June 27th. Okay, that was the thing. So drone was used. Drone is nothing but unmanned aerial vehicle because it is not having any humans pilot driving it. So this was in the news. So prima facie investigation conducted by security agents revealed that they could be the terrorists from the Lashkar-e-Toyba as found by the Jammu Kashmir police. So this is the news. Now, even after 2 days, they have not discovered any wreckage. That is very unique about it. Apparently because it's like a hit and run operation. Unmanned, drone came and attacked and left without leaving any trace, any debris. So there was no wreckage or any debris found at the site of the incident, at the scene of the crime, airport of the. So there was no technical evidence found at the Indian Airport, Jammu Airport section, and NSG team joined the NIA to investigate into this possibility of the using a long distance launching pad to send in drones with the payloads of equipment. So how long they can get? Now that's also very important for us to understand in the discussion that if it is so, there can be long range, like ballistic missile, can we have long range drones? They can travel to any distance and can also cause harm, carry payloads and of explosive and do the damage and destruction. So will we be fighting a remote war rather than the battle or war? So this is the, or what is called as a proxy war. This is the scenario because of the development of the drone attack. This is very startling and very matter of grave concern for us. And it really shows a breach in the security threat and that we need to prepare about it. Now it seems the drones may have managed to drop the payload and escape from the zone, like hit and run operation. They just dropped and left. So this was the context. And this was in the news item. So NIA NSG find no debris of drones at the GM Jammu Airbase. So fired upon at military installation army, but they were not finding any evidence. And two of the principal investigative agencies of the country, NIA and NSG, National Investigating Agency, National Security Guards, both of them could not find any evidence despite their expertise and technology at their command. The news is about the drone attack that was carried out 2 days back. There was no trace as found out by the preliminary investigation by the NIA and NSG, and it is suspected that Lashkar-e-Toyba group of terrorists could have operated, and it could have been a hit and run operation. So the two drones were flown from the border from the airport, Jammu Airport, which is only 14.5 kilometers away from the air base. Please try to understand, the Jammu Air Force base is about only 14.5 kilometers from the actual Jammu Airport, civilian Jammu Airport. And so perhaps it just flew hit and ran. So it is like hit and run operation. The drone is suspected to be flying at a height of 1.2 kilometers and would have been powered by long range batteries. So this is a very matter of grave concern for us. Let's see what is this drone about. All of you are aware, the drones are now the most important technology that we are dealing with. And we hear that in future, most of the medicines, even Swiggy, Zomato will be carrying drones in the future. Well, that's so far good. But imagine a nightmare scenario where drones will be carried to attack the humanity and population or strategic air bases or strategic military installations. Now, that is a nightmare scenario, apocalyptic scenario for us. So let's try to understand what is drone. Drone is a layman terminology for unmanned aerial vehicle. Actually, UAV it is. And they are remotely piloted aircraft, meaning there is no, it's unmanned and remotely controlled, independent, autonomous, and they consist of pilot station. They require command and control links and any other component as specified by the type design. What are the purposes of this drone? Drones are used for a range of purposes like package delivery, like I was telling you. Groceries also in future perhaps will be there as far as the marketing is concerned. in agriculture, spraying pesticides, monitoring. The mechanization is going to the point of drones now. Monitoring environmental changes, like for example, you want to monitor what is the sulfur dioxide in the air, what is the carbon monoxide in the air. So you can send a drone up at the altitude so that you can collect the samples. Aerial photography during search and relief operation, drones are very, very useful to carry out relief operation. So all these are used. But now we realize that it can be used for defense, for attack, for combat purpose. Now that is a dangerous scenario that is emerging. Try to find out how many types of drones are there. You see, they have been divided into five categories based on their weights. Nano less than or equal to 250 grams, micro 250 grams to 2 kg, small from 2 kg to 25 kg, and medium from 25 kg to 150 kg, large greater than 150 kg. So you see, if you see the large one, it can carry heavy payload and it can be enough to cause a mass destruction. You can carry perhaps WMD, weapons of mass destruction. Now this is quite alarming. And also poses a great threat to our security and a challenge to our defense system. What are the, these drone attacks have become a great matter of great concerns. Over the past 2 years, they have been deployed regularly by Pakistan-based outfits to smuggle arms, ammunition, and drugs into Indian territory. So drug trafficking, smuggling of the arms, ammunition. And they fly low. The problem with the drones is they fly very low and so they cannot be detected by radar. According to government figures, 167 drone sightings were recorded along the border with Pakistan in 2019. And in 2020, there were 77 such sightings. So increasing sightings of the drones for various misuse of various purposes like smuggling, ammunition, drug trafficking, now even attacking the air bases, installations, and there is a threat to security. Drones are becoming security threats, particularly in conflict zone, where non-state actors are active and have an easy access to technology. Pakistan is giving support, allowing terrorist groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba to operate from its soil or operate on its soil. And they are the non-state actors compared to those who are in the power, Mr. Imran Khan and his company. So the non-state actors are nothing but these terrorist outfits, Syed Hafiz and this Lashkar-e-Taiba outfits. So they are being given refuge and shelter and all the support, sponsorism by the state. And they always claim whenever there's an attack, oh, that was done by non-state actors. We are also victims of the terrorism. And so we don't support it. But there is a direct link between the nexus between the all these terrorist outfits that are aimed to attack India. Because they are providing the shelter. They are providing the habitation, settlements for the terrorist groups to train, operate against India. So now drones are being used as a part of that sponsored terrorism against India. So drones are becoming security threats in conflict zone where non-state actors are active. And so like example is 2019 twin drone attacks on Aramco crude oil production in Saudi Arabia. So now high seas also can be targets. And imagine now anything, any drone can fly from anywhere and can attack from any region and they cannot be detected also. That is the risk that we carry now because of drone. Earlier, at least space was safer. Now drones are going to invade into the area of space now. So now it is posing a great threat to the security for the police, for the security people, and for the military defense people to safeguard the frontiers of the things. So earlier it was only army, navy, and now we have to look at also space as a threat. So what makes combat drones in the hands of non-state actors? Why they are being increasingly used and what is the purpose? And they pose a great danger. They can deliver weapons of mass destruction from any point, remotely controlled operation systems. Let's see why the drones are becoming increasingly manipulated, mobilized and operated upon, mobilized, deployed by the terrorist outfits. Well, the reason for increasing drone attack is they are cheap. They are remotely controlled and they're cheap because it doesn't take much of the cost and also technology to assemble them and make drones. and can be made also natively, indigenously, and locally, and remotely controlled. So there is no risk of human loss of the person who is operating it. And then second is there is no danger to the people who are using that remotely controlled, to cause destruction at a site other than from where they are operating. And the other important, easy to operate, and easy to procure, easy to operate, and a great damage potential, like even it can carry weapons of mass destruction. Also important for any country to equip its forces with anti-drone combat. Now, looking at this increased mobilization and increased sightings of these drones, now we realize that we need to have a very good effective anti-drone combat technology in place to counter this. So we have framed the rules for drone regulation in India. Let's see what they are available. Unmanned aircraft system, UAS rules, says it's a set of rules notified by the government that aims to regulate the production, import, trade, ownership, establishment of the drone ports, also operation of the unmanned aircraft system rules. It seeks to create a framework for drones used by businesses. So business houses, like we mentioned about medicines, or agriculture, or groceries, or material, various purposes that we have used. All this can be rules, framework how to use for the businesses. Now we have what is called as anti-drone technology, which I mentioned about here. Because of increasing threat, we need to have anti-drone technology. Now we have anti-drone, national counter rogue drones guidelines. So if there are rogue drones that are mobilized with a potential threat to security and damage, that can cause damage, we need to have a national counter drones guidelines to counter the rogue drones. So they are not the ordinary drones, they are rogue drones. So national counter rogue drones guidelines. So in order to have effective combat, to combat effectively against this, drones which are posing a security threat and mobilized, which are mobilized by terrorist outfits like Lashkar-e-Toba in this case, or any such case in future. So any outfit for that matter. So places of critical and national importance, the rules call for deployment of a model that consists of primary and passive detection means. So like what is the radar? Of course, if they fly low, you can't detect. Then the radio frequency detectors, electro-optical, infrared. Infrared can be seen in the night during the dark. Even under the cover of dark, you can see in the pitch dark also, you can see the mobilization of these drones. So that is the purpose of infrared cameras. So they can detect. So we can detect through radar, radio frequency, and electro-optical in place. These are the strategies in place to detect any radars which are mobilized by enemy, either army, state actors, or non-state actors like terrorist outfits. In addition to this, soft kill and hard kill measures like RF jammers, radio frequency jammers, GPS, global position system, spoofers, lasers, and drone catching nets also suggested to be involved. So that means we can have all this in our place so that we can catch hold of the drones and see that they are neutralized much before they are causing any harm or mobilized for a purpose to cause harm. So that completes about the drone.